Hey YouTube, we still need your help to win a Streamy Award. We need you to go to Twitter and tweet the hashtag TKOR for Streamies. We need your vote, it's very important because your vote might be the one that tips us over and helps us win. Huh, that is not the scenario I would have predicted to see. Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back for another epic day of experimenting. I brought you outside today where I've got a 6-gallon gasoline fuel can as well as an electric hot plate. Kind of seems a little bit random, but it'll make sense in just a minute. Now the request for our experiment today came out of the comments from MixMonwathriat, who got 235 thumbs ups for asking the question, what happens when you boil gasoline? Now let's start off this project today by taking just a second to talk about what gasoline actually is. Now you may remember the story that back when I was 21 years old, I used to work on the oil rigs, drilling holes into the ground and extracting crude oil where it could be shipped off and refined into products like gasoline. Now if you've ever pulled up to the gas station, you probably noticed different octane ratings for the fuel. You've got regular and you've got premium. And what those numbers are telling you is how much compression that liquid can take before self-igniting. Now if you ever want to try storing gasoline, it's important that you use containers that comply with the regulations of the EPA. Gasoline is a very volatile liquid, and depending on the temperature and pressure, it may cause the container you have it stored in to erode or explode. Even this 6-gallon container that is compliant with the EPA, you can see how much pressure is built up inside. This thing is bulging and ready to burst. There's a lot of pressure sitting in there right now. So the purpose of today's experiment is to see what will happen if we put gasoline in an open container on a hot plate and let it boil. Will the gasoline actually boil at all, or will it just vaporize into the air? And if it does start boiling, will those bubbles foam up and froth over and spill over into the hot plate itself? And is it possible for gasoline to actually get hot enough to self-ignite? We're answering those three questions in this video today. All right, so quick update, these nozzles are much more trouble than they're worth. We're just gonna scrap them and pour directly from the container. That should be more than enough. So here we are guys, I've just transferred the gasoline from our jerry can into this Pyrex glass. This can hold about 2 cups, right now I've got it leveled about 1.5 cups. Now it's important to note that right now we're being very careful not to have any open flames because obviously the vapor that's coming off this right now is extremely flammable and we don't want this thing to ignite prematurely. Now we're using Pyrex for this first experiment. As a backup plan, I'm gonna stick a pot down underneath it so that way if the glass cracks, we'll be able to contain the gasoline in the pot without it spilling over onto the burner. All right, about to turn it on. The starting temperature right now is surprisingly only about 13.7 Celsius. When I look at the actual hot plate itself, just on the edges, we're showing 40 degrees Celsius. There's a dramatic difference. I think that's from keeping this in cold storage. Yep, that's definitely cold. So let's turn the heat on, let her rip, and we'll see what happens. It's been about 10 minutes. I just came back to check and you can already see some white fumes are coming off. I see little bubbles coming from the bottom of the gasoline. I don't see it boiling yet, but when I measure the temperature, it's showing about 58 degrees Celsius. That has warmed up quite a bit from where it was 10 minutes ago. So we let this thing run another 5 to 10 minutes and we'll check in on it then. Dang, that's increasing fast. So at 60 degrees Celsius, I think if this stuff explodes in our face accidentally, we'll just remember to stop, drop, and roll. It should solve all our problems, right?
Look at that. If you look down here, you can actually see it's bubbling from the bottom.
We did not even make it to 5 minutes, guys. I just checked in on this, and it's actually bubbling. If you look at the surface, you can see bubbles coming up to the top and collecting. Measuring the temperature, I'm showing we're at about 82 degrees Celsius. So this is actually boiling under the boiling point of water. So gasoline will boil, and it'll boil before water does. That's interesting. So now the question is, how hot can we actually get this? If we leave this on the burner plate, how hot will that liquid get before it either bursts into flames or boils off completely? The gasoline is showing over 145 degrees Celsius. That's like 280 degrees Fahrenheit right now. That's really, really hot. Look at all the vapor that's coming off. It's a tremendous amount. At this point, I'm thinking that whole thing is gonna boil completely dry without igniting at all, which is kind of surprising. I mean, I thought maybe it would get hot enough to light into flames, but without an open source of flames, apparently it'd have to get quite a bit hotter. It almost looks like the gasoline itself is getting concentrated as well. It's not quite as clear as it used to be. It's a lot more of a darker yellowish orange. So something in there is obviously getting concentrated out. That's amazing. That's almost completely gone. It's very, very hot. Very hot to the touch. Woo! Very hot to the touch. I'm just gonna let this boil down completely because I wanna see as it gets toward the bottom, is it going to accelerate and actually burst into flames at all? All right, we're on the home stretch. You can see all the vapor coming out now. This is happening very quickly. I should probably get a reading. About 180 degrees Celsius, 370 degrees Fahrenheit. That's pretty dang hot. Obviously, that's about as hot as it can get on its own. So what if we let this boil off we let the temperature come up even higher, and then we pour in a little bit of gasoline to that heightened temperature already. Will it just boil or will it burst into flames? That is our next experiment. Queso, look at that. There's some kind of interesting residue at the bottom there. Some kind of a brownish, motor oily looking stuff. See that? This is actually so hot right now, I'm having trouble hanging on to it. CO2 fire extinguisher. I value my skin, so we're bringing out the big guns for safety. That should be good enough. For this one, we're gonna get crazy and try something a little bit different. I'm gonna pull the pot out of the scenario and put the Pyrex directly onto the burner itself. That should give it a little bit more heat. I'm just gonna give that a few more minutes to heat up to maximum, then we're gonna take a small cup of gasoline and pour it directly in the center. Good idea, bad idea? We're about to find out. Oh my gosh. Now that we took that pot off, the temperature's going up dramatically. 640 Fahrenheit. And the glass, we're already up to 430. That's cool. I wonder if this will work after all. Putting the glass directly on the burner is making a dramatic difference to how much heat is actually going into the glass. I think the pot was acting as a heat sink and deflecting some of that off. So we're gonna bring this thing up till it's about 250 degrees Celsius, which is extremely hot. And then we're gonna throw the gasoline in. Before I pour this thing, I'm gonna do one final check. So I'm showing pretty close to 300 degrees Celsius, which is over 550 degrees Fahrenheit. This is absolutely ridiculous. This setup right now is actually hotter than the inside of your oven can actually get. So if this does not ignite without a flame, I'm gonna actually feel a lot safer about handling gasoline. Moment of truth, here we go. Now I'm just gonna kind of stand off to the side here in case something goes terribly wrong. I'm gonna dump it all in one go. In 3, 2, 1. Oh, and it broke the glass. That was not actually the reaction I was expecting. I was thinking maybe it would go off in flames, maybe it would just sit in there and boil, but it actually cracked the Pyrex, spilled out over the burner, all over the cement. No sign of flames whatsoever, just a lot of broken glass. Huh. Okay, so here comes the liquid. You can see it coming down from the top. Half of it goes in a container, the other half kind of splashes out on the burner and all over the pavement. And you can actually see the gasoline inside the container like erupting, shooting back up out of the top. And there goes the side of the glass cracking. Obviously some kind of an issue with thermal shock, the two extremes meeting, cold gasoline and a very hot glass container. So if that didn't light off, I don't know what would. Obviously at some point it is gonna be a surface hot enough to ignite the gasoline, but that's gonna be extreme temperatures beyond anything that we can generate using an oven or an electric burner. And that's good news. I do feel like we have to have some kind of fire though. So I'm gonna take this residual over here and light it off. Oh, most of it's evaporated. I guess there's a little bit of a flame there, but it's hard to see in the daylight. We started off this experiment today to see exactly what would happen if we put gasoline on a hot burner and raised the temperature quickly. The first thing we observed was the gasoline warmed up and began to boil, but the bubbles did not turn into a frothy foam and spill over the edge. Instead, they just popped and vaporized into the air. After about 15 to 20 minutes, we noticed most of the gasoline had vaporized off, but the temperature never actually rose high enough for those vapors to self-ignite. The reason is because all the energy going to the gasoline to vaporize it kept the liquid at a very constant temperature, somewhere around 160 degrees Celsius. When all that gas vaporized out of the container, we decided to try a second experiment to see if we could heat the container up even hotter and pour the gasoline into that. The question being, would a container that was twice as hot as the boiling point of gasoline get it to auto-ignite? But in pouring the gasoline into the container, what we found was rather than the gas igniting, the glass container actually broke. Now, of course, glass isn't the best material to use, but we also saw that as the gasoline spilled down over the extremely hot burner, no reaction happened. Nothing lit on fire. It just spilled down onto the ground and began to vaporize into the atmosphere, so we grabbed a blowtorch and tried to light off the rest. Based on the results of this experiment, I'm a lot more confident working with gasoline now. Now, obviously, if you got a surface hot enough, you could get the gasoline to ignite. Back when I was playing with my solar scorcher in concrete, I poured gasoline onto the concrete and that was hot enough to light the gasoline vapors off just with the power of the sun. So if concentrated sunlight will do that, I'm sure there's a temperature where we can get gasoline to flash into ignition. However, using the kind of equipment like ovens, stoves, and electric burners that we have around the house, it's not likely to happen, and that's good news. Well, there you have it, guys. We have successfully answered the question, what happens when you boil gasoline? And a big thanks to you, MixmonWathriad, for putting this suggestion down in the comments. You can go check your YouTube inbox because we're sending you $25. Now, quick disclaimer, this is not an experiment I want you to try at home. Playing with gasoline is extremely dangerous, and if it gets on your skin, you may never look the same for the rest of your life. For this experiment, we had safety protocols in place, a giant carbon dioxide fire extinguisher, we are using an electric burner, and no open sources of ignition. Replicating this kind of experiment on top of an open flame, like a fire pit, for example, would yield much different results. That's not something I recommend trying at home. So thanks for joining us for this experiment, guys. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. And that, my friends, is how you clean gasoline off your driveway. We're almost out of time for the streamies. The votes are almost in. So right now, jump over to Twitter, cast your vote, TKOR for streamies. We'd love to win an award, but thank you in advance, because that one vote that tips the balance into our favor and helps us win just might be yours.